grew up on the Mississippi coast and spent a lot of time out on the Mississippi barrier islands, and from the barrier islands on a clear night you can just see that lighthouse. So when I was growing up and spending time out there back in the 60s, it was a symbol to me of exotic places that were just beyond my reach, someplace I always wanted to go to.
The lighthouse became a focal point for a lot of stuff for all of us. So we worked in the Chandeleur Islands, being Louisiana's premier barrier island system. The lighthouse happened to be a way to find our way home at night, many, many nights, a way to go from Biloxi to the island. It was part of our life, you know.
So when I started working here, and one of the first field trips I went with Shay was to the Chandeleur Islands, and it was a realization of one of my childhood dreams, so to speak. And to me, lighthouses in general kind of symbolize this point of stability, constancy in a completely changing, constantly changing environment. It's just this welcome symbol. When you come from far off and you see the lighthouse, you know you've gotten there. You've arrived somewhere far away. Safety, you know, the lighthouse being safety.
First time I saw it, I was in the back of my dad's plane. We'd take off from Gulfport Airport, and typical Dave was we'd wait till the tide was right because we'd had to land on the sand out there. And as soon as you got about 700-800 feet, you could see the tip of the island, past Ship Island. And then you see the lighthouse sticking up there, and we'd fly right by it. I'd always want to wave. Of course, there's nobody in the wind at the time. We landed in front of it pretty often because it had the easiest place to land in front of the sandbar right there.
Oh, it had a tremendous amount of professional, but just as much as personal experience, too. The number of the weeks, the months we spend in the island, it's the way that you find your way around in the islands. You know, day or night, it becomes a benchmark by which we all calibrate ourselves on finding our location, getting home, watching coastal change. I think for anyone who goes to the Chandeleur Islands, when they leave the Chandeleur Islands, they leave with an image of the lighthouse now overlooking this large barrier island arc in Louisiana.
It had a lean to it. Like when you were walking on the steps, you could tell a little sway to it. And not all the steps were there, and there was some broken glass probably from where the protection around the light was. But it also made you wonder what it had been like to be one of the lighthouse keepers up there going up at night to work on the light. Because you could see these burned out pylons and posts on the ground around it, and you could tell that probably used to be an outbuilding. Either somebody stored equipment for the lighthouse or somebody lived in there. But once you were up there, you could hear the breeze, and it wasn't city noise. You know, it was just noise from birds passing by. Real relaxing, I thought.
So the lighthouse was an endpoint to a long survey of Louisiana coast, and to see it there, still there, always there, was just the closing statement in a survey along the coast. An inventory of habitats and landscapes within Louisiana. And from a boat, of course, it was a welcome sight, you know, just that symbol of it's still there, it's still working, you know, good reference point.
We always use it as a reference point. Us being in a small boat, you know, 20-foot boat, and we're halfway between Ship Island and Chandeleur, and we can see the lighthouse and the water's calm, well, we know we can make it. Kind of like hopscotching across the Mississippi Sound and the Gulf of Mexico.
Back in 1987, I actually climbed it, took pictures from up in it, decided that wasn't a real good idea when I saw chains holding it together. That was the last time I physically touched it that I can think, that I can remember. And then, of course, when we flew back out after Katrina, it was almost grief at losing a dear one when you realize it is not there. It was a very sad event for me, kind of an ending of an era.
I knew the lighthouse Chandeleur was already in the water, and so when somebody told me it was gone, then it kind of made sense, but it still hurt because it's kind of like a part of your history growing up. You don't expect it to be gone.
It's actually very amazing that the lighthouse lasted so long. We watched the lighthouse through the 1985 hurricanes. There was three that year. The lighthouse had weathered so many storms over the decades that Katrina took it out, and it was a big surprise to us. It's gone.